Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to look at how to use Cython to wrap existing C libraries and make them accessible in Python. I've covered Cython before in this channel and on InfoWorld. It's a dialect of Python that compiles to C, which makes it easy to write C extensions for Python. One of the other benefits it gives you is the ability to take existing C libraries and make wrappers for them in Cython. So you can make a Python library interface to a C library, and you can make the wrapping for that C library as minimal or maximal as you like. And you can write it in what amounts to Python. So let's start with a simple example in Windows. I have here a library that I threw together in C. It's actually C++, but it exposes its function calls externally through the C interfaces. And this library just has one function in it, inverse. And all it does is takes in a Boolean value and returns its opposite. And along with the source, we've got this compiled DLL from it here. We have the header file and the linking library. So I want to take all of this and I want to use it natively in Python just by being able to do a Python level import. Now, Python does have a native way to load and work with libraries called C-types. And for quick and dirty one-off jobs, C-types can work just fine. Here's an example of using C-types in action for this sort of thing. I can load the library in question, and I can access its functions through Python object interfaces. But one of the disadvantages of using C-types is there's a lot of calling overhead for each use of the functions. So if you're doing stuff in a loop, for instance, you're going to want to cut down the amount of per-call overhead, the going back and forth between the C and the Python layers of things. And Cython lets you do that. You can make those function calls natively in C, side by side with the existing code that you write. So to wrap this DLL with Cython, what we do is we take each function call that we want to expose from the DLL, and we write a corresponding entry for it in our Cython file. And Cython has a syntax for doing this, cdef extern from, where we point to the header file we want to use, and then we make declarations for each function that we want to expose through it. We don't have to make a binding for every single function in the library if we don't need it. We just expose what we need. So next, we create the setup.py file to compile the Cython file. And the exact details here do matter. So we have the internal name for the module we're compiling, the file that it corresponds to, and then we have these three lines, the libraries, library dirs, and include dirs. And these point at the actual DLL and the locations where we can find the header and the link files. Without this, the compilation process won't work. So now we compile this with setup.py build extension in place. And once that's done, we now have a Python C library. And to make use of it, I have a simple Python program here. You'll notice that because we don't have the DLL in the same directory as the Cython module we built, we have to use this function, os.addLLDirectory, to add a fully qualified path to where the DLL is that we're wrapping. See, depending on how you're working with your wrapped library, you might need to do this. But if you're just deploying your wrapped library side by side with your compiled module, that should work as is. But I have included this for the sake of being explicit. So once we establish that, we can just import wrapper, that's our Cython module, and use inverse to call our function. By the way, ignore the error message in the linter, because as you can see, the program does work. Now, if you followed my previous talks about Cython, you know Cython has two dialects. The older Cython dialect that you've just seen, and a newer pure Python dialect, as it's called. This is one that looks like regular Python. This pure Python mode, as it's called, is easier to work with for the most part, but it has a drawback. It doesn't support the syntax we just saw for binding to external libraries. So how would we do this if we wanted to use pure Python mode? The answer actually turns out to be fairly simple. We take our old Cython code, which is actually going to be nothing but these header declarations that we had, and we put that into a file with the extension .pxd. And a .pxd file provides declarations for an accompanying Cython file with the same name. So when we create our module wrapper.py and compile that with Cython, Cython will look in wrapper.pxd for any declarations to apply to it. Now, one of the other things that we can do with these declarations is alias them. This is something we can do in legacy Cython mode too, but I'm showing you here for the sake of demonstration. See, if we use this version of the declaration here, what's happening is we're using underscore inverse as the name to expose to the Cython side of things, but it will be binding to the name inverse in the DLL. So this way we can take the functions in our DLL and use them in an aliased form when we wrap them. And I'll show you what I mean and why this is useful. Here's the Cython file for this version of the wrapper. You'll notice that it exposes the function inverse, which is available to the Python programmer when they import this module. But when it calls our DLL, it calls a function named underscore inverse. This keeps us from having a name collision. And that means that we can expose names to the Python user that map to what they know is available in the DLL, but we can write our own code to go with it. So we can write a full-blown wrapper function where we can do more with the input and the output. Like we could do computation with it, or we could loop over function calls to the DLL and do those efficiently. In this case, we're just returning the original and the modified values together as a Python tuple. And note that we don't explicitly import underscore inverse anywhere. That's because the PXD file is supplying that when we do the compilation. So if we compile this code and we run our example of it, we now get back two values instead of one. We've created our own little Python wrapper for the function, so we can expose that function as is, or we can do additional work with it as needed for our sake. One more thing is worth pointing out. There is a chance that in the future, we could see a pure Python mode implementation of this wrapping behavior, and that way we wouldn't need to use a PXD file to accomplish this magic. Now, if that ever happens, I will be sure to make a follow-up video in which I talk about how that works, but for now, the PXD method works for both the old and the new Cython syntaxes, and it's going to be supported for a good long time to come, so we can continue to use that as is. And that's it for this video for now. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.